If you want to work with candies, now you get it. Today we will make this little beauty called a lollipop, with all its sugary, syrupy texture. So, let's hop into a new blend file. Of course, the first thing we need to do is the modeling part. We insert an UV sphere first, go into edit mode and select all the faces in the middle, which means both of this face and edge loops. Now we press E and instantly right click, press S, shift Z to lock it to the X and Y axis and scale it outwards a little bit. In the edge select mode, we just select the middle edge loop, press S and scale it a little bit outwards. Then go back to the object mode, press W and shade smooth. Also go to the object data properties under normals and select auto smooth. In the modifiers tab, we now add a subdivision surface modifier on level 2. So everything is smoothed out quite a bit. Also, we go back to edit mode, press Ctrl R and insert a loop cut right over and under our extrusion. If we go out of the edit mode, we now have a nice, sharp and clean beveled edge. Congratulations! You finished two-thirds of the modeling part. You can always adjust the modifier to higher values, but I will leave it at 2 since it's already getting pretty good results. Next, we want to add a cylinder to create the handle. So, we add a cylinder, go to edit mode and scale it down with shift Z. So we just scale down the thickness of the cylinder. Scale it down until it looks like a handle. You can always activate the wireframe mode. Now press G, Z and bring it down until you're in a position where you want the handle to stop inside the lollipop. Then go back to edit mode and select the bottom vertices. Then press G and Z to extrude it down until it's reached the stage you want. As the last step, go out of edit mode, press W, shade smooth, and in the object data properties, enable auto smooth. And this is all the magic we needed. Now we have 3 options. We can parent the objects together. We can add a Boolean modifier. Or we can join and clean up the geometry so everything is a single object. For the sake of simplicity, I will opt for the first option. So, go out of X-ray mode and add an empty object. You can increase the size so you can better see it in the viewport. Then select the lollipop and the handle and as last thing, the empty. Then press Ctrl P and set parent to object. With this action, we finally finished the modeling of our lollipop. The next part will also be a pretty quick part of the tutorial. First, let's add a material to both of our objects. Then we go to the shading workspace. The first thing we need is an HDRI texture in our world settings, so we have a nice and clean lighting without worrying about anything. I will now choose an HDRI from HDRI Haven. The link is in the description. And then you can go to the viewport shading. I go to the front view to see better and position my view a bit more. Okay, first let's start with the handle, since this will be a quick shading. We select the handle, we lower the value of our color a bit, then we bring down the specula to 0.1 and the roughness to 0.9. That's it for the handle. Now select the candy part of the lollipop. We will choose a bright red color. Then we change the specula to 0.7 and the roughness to 0.4. Now we will make a bit of space. Then we add a mix shader and a translucent shader, which mix together. And we choose the same color from the candy and bring it more to the whites a little bit. Now we change the factor of the mix shader to 0.6. As you can see, now we get a nice translucent thing here. If I go up, nothing happens. If I go down, you can see more of the handle. If you look at it right now, it doesn't look so good. We now take the step to make it look like actual candy. We duplicate the mix node and place it before our actual node. Bring the factor back to 0.5. Now we add a transparent node into our setup. We change the color to the same color of our translucent node and plug it into the mix shader in the last open slot. Now we have a nice syrupy look. It's already pretty nice. You can see the handle right through the candy, but if you look at it, something is still missing. And you know what it is? It looks too perfect. So we need a bit of displacement. A noise texture is taking care of this for us. So we go to texture and add a noise texture. Go to the preview and we don't need nothing more to do. We crank up the details to 16 and plug it into a color ramp. Then we strengthen the dark parts a bit and plug the result into the height socket of a bump node. Then we plug the result in the normal and it looks pretty ugly. So we need to bring down the strength a bit. I think around 0.3 is perfect. Alright, and this is the finished lollipop. It looks pretty good, has a slight translucence and a little bump. For VFX and models, this is a pretty good thing. And this is everything for the tutorial. As always, if you liked the video, be sure to smash the like button, leave a subscription and tell me in the comments what you would like to see next. If you are interested in the blend file, look into the description, there you will find the corresponding links. As a Patreon, this file will be accessible for everyone. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and we will see us next time.